The deceased students have been identified as Aloysius Ahewa and Malik Katende. Those critically injured include Christina Dong, the school matron, Austin Kisembo, Alpha Waswa, Aloysius Ahewa, Jordan Sendagide, Arnold Tumwesije, Sherid Mwanje, among others. They were rushed to Masaka Regional Referral Hospital, where parents gathered quickly to check on their children. A parent called me and told me our children's dormitory had caught fire. I also decided to call and inform other parents. I didn't believe the news at first, until I found someone who confirmed to me that the dormitory was on fire.
Police are more technical of the findings. So it's incumbent upon them to produce what is expected of them.
It's very unfortunate for the parents whose children have been affected by this, but there is no, from our ill motive, I mean, from our assessment, there shouldn't be any kind of saying maybe there was an ill motive.
According to Charles Tumushime, the hospital administrator for Masaka Regional Referral Hospital, they received 10 victims, of which 9 have been referred to Chirudu Hospital for further treatment.
Our emergency unit is fully equipped to handle emergencies, but in some instances when you get such a cases that need a super specialized service, and depending on the condition of the patient, like for example, if they may need the ICU in the process, which we don't have, we transfer the patients to be managed by where they can get a highly specialized care.
Jamada Wandera, the acting Greater Masaka Police spokesperson, attributed the incident to a short circuit.
The fire suspected to have started from a socket where the matron could have put the phone charging, the way we have assessed. So the probable cause of the fire could have been a power short circuit. We have done whatever we can to calm down the situation. Parents have come around to check on their children, and we have been able to show them the children who are around.
It's very unfortunate. We grieve with the families, and we extend the information to all school owners and the rectors to take caution of all the possible causes of fire, and where possible we are looking forward to getting the reports from the police on the causes of this fire.
He however regretted that the police fire and rescue team could not save the two students, although it rushed to the scene.
Fire brigade, which rushed to the scene, upon reaching there, they found when at least fire had been put down by those concerned, and they tried fire brigade now embarked on putting off fire which was already in the ceiling. The dormitory which is affected accommodates children of top class and P1, and they were about 15 who reside in that dormitory with a matron.
Earlier this month, a fire outbreak was reported at Masaka Senior Secondary School in Masaka City. This incident brings the number of school fire cases reported in Masaka City to 2 in a period of 1 month. Report compiled by Fiona Nanyomo for the news.